Does this describe you? One, you have ideas for apps that could make money. Two, you don't know how to code. And three, you're broke. Then this video was made for you because I'm going to explain step by step how you can take your app ideas and build a complete working app with no money and no technical skills. Just blood, sweat, tears, and other bodily fluid YouTube won't allow me to say. Since you're new to app development, you might not know this. Let me pop your cherry. Most apps fail. Also, Santa isn't real, and you are adopted. When I say most apps fail, I don't mean they don't work. I mean nobody wants to use them. App store front pages are where all popular apps hang out. But for every Asana or ClickUp, there are tons of task management tools that just gather digital dust. Does this mean ClickUp and Asana are a million times better than them? No. It just means most apps fail. The same way water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius, it just does. You need to get used to this if you are going to make it in the app game. I have more to say about this, but I'll save the lecture for later. First, let's talk about how you're going to build your app. Find a no-code app builder. No-code app builders are platforms that allow anyone to build apps without having to write code. Doesn't mean there's literally no code. It just means you're not the one writing it. No-code app builders have blocks of pre-written code that serve specific functions. You drag and drop these blocks of code onto a blank app screen. Depending on the block, you can customize it slightly to fit your app. For example, we're looking at Adalo, a very popular option. And here the user has customized a generic listing block for a property app. Well, you do the same thing with all your app screens. Then you link them up, connect them to a database, and just like magic, you have an app. Adalo has a free plan where you can learn how to use it and build your app. Every no-code app builder has a free plan, but free plan doesn't mean free lunch. They want to lock you in and leave you no choice but to eventually upgrade to paid plans. How do they lock you in? Let's keep using Adalo as an example. You build an app on their platform with their blocks of code. You cannot export the code. Your app only works on Adalo. Now, let's look at their pricing in more detail. Their free plan 100% lets you build your app, but what else? You can publish it as a web application, but on an Adalo domain. You can integrate Stripe. You get a few monthly app actions or usage. And that's it. If you want to publish it on app stores, a custom domain, integrate more advanced features, you need to pay. It's not just Adalo. It's the same for all no-code app builders. But you get to build a fully functional app for free. And you only upgrade to paid plans if the app gets traction and starts to make money. Then it's your turn to lock your users in and make them pay. The circle of life. Adalo's paid plan starts at $45 a month. If paying 45 bucks can get you 200, pay the damn 45 bucks. And it doesn't have to be Adalo. There are so many options out there. Finding the right one is like going down a rabbit hole. You'll never be seen again. There's no perfect builder. There's the right one for you depending on your idea. Is it a simple or complex app? Is it a web or mobile application or both? What about usage patterns? Will people use it for 2 minutes every day or a few hours once a week? Do you want the option of exporting the code? A few app builders offer them. Without knowing your requirements, I can only give general recommendations. So here they are. For simple mobile application, Adalo. For simple web apps, software. For complex mobile apps, Thunkable. For complex web applications, WeWeb. For mobile app code export, Flutterflow or Dropbit. And for web app code export, Plasmic. All have free plans, so you can learn the platform and build and validate your app for free. But with all of them, if your app goes big, you need to get a paid plan to meet growing demand. Fair enough. Links to them are in the description, and all of my recommended app builders have comprehensive tutorials, guides, and showcase pages where they share apps built with their platform. Check out the showcases to see if others have built similar apps to your idea. It's more fun to learn as you build, but it's not the fastest, and you'll make a lot of mistakes. Learn first, build later. It makes you better and faster at both. If you do this, you might take 2 weeks to become proficient at basics for simpler app builders like software. For complex builders like Flutterflow, give yourself a month. You probably have a life to live, so I won't clock you on this. But once you're proficient at the platform, in my opinion, it should take you no more than 12 to 16 weeks to launch your app by yourself. But if you don't want to, and you're not broke, I have a solution. My team and I at Upstack Studio help businesses grow past $5 to $10 million in annual revenue with custom software. We've worked with over 30 leading brands from different industries. They all face the same sticking point, tech. Specifically, generic, off-the-shelf software was no longer enough to solve their problems. If they wanted to keep growing, it was time for a custom solution, where we come in. Most developers charge per hour, which puts a lot of risk on you, since it can end up costing a lot more because of discoveries. At Upstack Studio, we use fee packages based on 8 years in app development. Once we know your requirements, we'll see which package fits best, and if we are wrong, the price you're quoted at the start is still the price you pay at the end. If your business is also currently stuck at 5 to 10 million a year, and you feel like custom software could help break past that, let's talk. There's a link in the description to sign up for a free, no strings attached strategy session. We'll go over your current constraints and you get honest feedback on whether custom software can help. Apply through the link and we'll be in touch. I'm only taking 3 of these calls per month and it's first come first served. So if you want to work with me, act now. Back to the video. What? You are broke? Time to do it yourself. Here's how. Zero to launch. After 8 years of doing this for a living, my team and I have found 12 to 16 weeks is the sweet spot for taking most apps from idea to launch ready. Of course, we are real developers. We don't need no-code app builders. These fingers are all I need. By the way, your fingers is also all you need to hit the thumbs up button. Anyways, our process is easily adapted to a solo founder working with a no-code app builder. Here's a week-by-week breakdown. Just a warning, it's gonna get a bit nerdy. Week 1, define your app's purpose and essential features. Start by answering these questions. Who is your app for? Define your ideal users and their main pain points. What problem does your app solve? Focus on a specific solution. Use these steps to narrow your scope. List users and actions. Identify key app users, for example, buyers and sellers. Map their goals. Determine what each user needs to achieve through your app. Prioritize features. Cut any features your app can succeed without. By the end of week 1, you should have a clear understanding of your target audience, the features of your app, and a basic wireframe of your app screens. Week 2, start building, relearning, and fixing mistakes. Yes, by now you would have already gone through the app builder tutorials and guides. I guarantee when you start building, you will make mistakes anyways. So you'll be slow. Give yourself week 2 to become really proficient at your app builder's user interface. Think of learning the guitar. The first week of playing, if I told you to hit a G, you'll know what it is in theory. But there's a gap between theoretical understanding and practical application. You'll be counting one fret at a time. After a week like this, your fingers will instantly fly to the right fret. You know where exactly the G spot is. By the end of week 2, you should be familiar enough with your no-code app builder that when you want to do something, most of the time, you already know where it is. Week 3, finalizing your first prototype. Now that you're familiar with your app builder, time to nail those screens, the workflows, everything. By the end of week 3, you should have a functional prototype of your app with essential features and screens. Week 4, getting initial user feedback. Find at least 5 people, ideally part of your target audience. But if you can't find them, find 5 friends or family members and ask them to roleplay as target audience members. If you don't have 5 friends, then congratulations, you are definitely app founder material. Ask your users to go through the app and test its usability, focusing on whether the core features work. If the feedback is that core features work, but the app could look nicer, you've done a good job. If the core features don't work, you need to get to work. Week 5 to 8, keep building and getting feedback. If feedback is your core features don't work, now you have week 5 to 8 to get them to work. And if they already work, use this time to make it look nicer and more intuitive. Experiment with different color themes, simplify the navigation bar, shorten the copy. There's always something you can do to improve your app. And of course, along the way, every time you solve a problem or make a key change, get feedback from your users to confirm the problem is indeed solved. By the end of week 8, you should have a launch-ready MVP. Week 9 to 10, preparing for launch. If you have never launched a mobile app on app stores, it's not as hard as launching a rocket, but it takes some work. Before going live, make sure your app is ready to face users with all the necessary app descriptions and screenshots. This is called App Store Optimization, and I covered it in full in this video. But even if you're launching a web app, you want to make sure you at least have a landing page to pull in traffic and user onboarding documentation to guide new users. I would recommend HubSpot's marketing suite for your landing pages. There's a million tools out there to help with both. If your app builder happens to have it, go for that. Week 11 to 12, launch and gather feedback. Finally, launch your app to your audience. Share it with your network, post it on social media, and ask for reviews. Be on the lookout for critical bugs, address any major issues users report, feature request, take note of popular suggestions for future updates. And you should also be prepared for nothing, just crickets. Unless your target audience is actual crickets, in which case, just make shit jokes like me. They'll come. Look, there's a good chance that your app is just one of those that doesn't make it. It can be demotivating as hell to put in all that hard work and not make any money out of it. But now you know you have the discipline to learn a no-code platform and bring an app to life. There are so many business opportunities just from that alone. And other app ideas will come your way. You might need to learn other platforms, but that's fine. App ideas change. Platform and tools change. The process stays the same. And if you have the right process and the right mindset, it's just a matter of time before you succeed. If you found this video useful, could you help me reach the million others just like you? Leave a like and a comment. Ask me questions about app development. Tell me what topics you would like me to cover. Or if you're one of those who doesn't have 5 friends, find buddies in the comments, just don't be creepy. All this engagement tells YouTube to share this video to a wider audience and will make a bigger impact. Now, like I said, choosing a no-code app builder is like choosing a wife. There's no such thing as perfect, as long as it does the dishes and makes you a sandwich when you tell it. Or else, I've got a video on 7 most important metrics to measure any no-code app builders. Based on these metrics, you can be your own judge on whether or not it's right for you. That's all for this video. Let's see how to evaluate no-code app builders.